गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक। सो लेट अस कंटिन्यू विद चैप्टर नंबर 2, दैट इज एडिशन एंड सब्ट्रैक्शन। वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड द एडिशन पार्ट। वी हैड रिकॉर्डेड 3 वीडियोस फॉर एडिशन, यू कैन ऑल सी दैट फॉर बेसिक काइंड ऑफ एग्जांपल्स। नाउ इन दिस वीडियो वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग विद सब्ट्रैक्शन। ओके, नाउ जस्ट लाइक आई स्पोक अबाउट एडिशन स्टूडेंट्स, फॉर सब्ट्रैक्शन ऑल्सो दिस थिंग इज लर्न्ड बाय यू मे बी फ्रॉम स्टैंडर्ड 1 or standard 2, you are dealing with small numbers. Standard 3, I think you are dealing with number up to thousands and 10,000s. Standard 4, rule of subtraction will be same. You will be dealing with more bigger numbers up to, I think, lakhs or 10 lakhs. I hope everyone is very clear from standard 3rd with the method of borrow from subtraction. If not, we will see certain sums and this subtraction will be very clear. Okay? So as you can see, sir has written 2 questions for subtraction. We will solve both the questions together and we will also revise the method of this borrow and how we are doing the subtraction thing. Okay, fine. So let us start with the first question. I can read 78,91,253 minus 53,40,142. So sir will write here 78,91,253 minus 53,40,142. Okay, so I think this is a very simple sum where maybe no carry or no borrow will be there. Let us see. 3 minus 2. 3 minus 2 is 1. 5 minus 4, 1. 2 minus 1, 1. 1 minus 0, 1. 9 minus 4, how you are doing? 9 minus 4, just calculate. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So what is coming? 5. 8 minus 3, what is 8 minus 3? Again 5. And 7 minus 5 is 2. So this was a very simple question where no borrowing was there. But rest assured, we will have also do certain questions where technique of borrow is actually revised. Let us write the second question. 3, 9, 1, 8, 7, 2, 9 minus 2, 4, 0, 5, 3, 1, 6. Correct? Let's do it quickly. 9 minus 6, 3. 2 minus 1, 1. 7 minus 3, you can calculate. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. How many is coming? 4. 8 minus 5, 8 minus 5 will be 3. 1 minus 0, 1. 9 minus 4, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. How much is coming? 5 and 3 minus 2 is definitely 1. Okay. So this was simple subtraction, I think, without any borrowing. You can just see it. So rules are all the same, just the numbers are bigger. Now we will see some sums based on subtraction that uses the technique of borrowing. Okay. Just wait. Okay, students, I have written the third question. 752,717. So 752,717 minus 424,899. So sir will write this 752,717. Okay, minus 424,899. Okay, please see this carefully. 7 minus 9 is possible? No. So what we will do, we will make this 17, correct? 7 minus 9 is not possible. So we are making 7 as 17 and for that we are borrowing 1 from here. So 1 becomes 0. Okay? I hope you are understanding. This is revision from 2nd and 3rd standard. 7 minus 9 is not possible, correct? So we are making 7 as 17 and to make 7 into 17 we are borrowing 1 from this. If we are borrowing 1, 1 becomes 0. Now 17 minus 9, you can calculate on the end. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. What is coming? 8. Correct? Now is 0 minus 9 possible? No. So again we are borrowing 1 from here. If we are borrowing, this becomes 6 and this becomes 10. Correct? I again repeat, 0 minus 9 is not possible. So we borrowed 1 from the previous number. The previous number was 7. If we are borrowing 1, this becomes 6 and our number is become 10. So 10 minus 9 is 1. Correct? 6 minus 8, is it possible? No chance. So if 6 minus 8 is not possible, we will borrow 1 from here. 2 will become 1 and 6 will become 16. Just calculate. 16 minus 8 will be 8. Correct? 1 minus 4 is possible? No chance. So we will borrow 1 from here. 5 will become 4. 1 will become 11. 11 minus 4, just calculate. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. It is coming 7. Correct? 4 minus 2, it is possible. 4 minus 2 is 2 and 7 minus 4 is 3. Okay? So students, this way you will be dealing with sums based on the method of carryover. You can see it once more to have a better understanding. Fine? We will now do one more sum based on carryover. Okay. I will write the question in a different manner so that find difference between say 689,158 and okay. So sir has written the question. Find difference between 689,158 and 178,498. So what is the meaning of the word difference, students? The meaning of the word difference is, again, you have to find the difference. That means you have to subtract. Okay? So let me write the question. 689,158 minus 178,498. Correct? Let us start. 8 minus 8, 0. 8 minus 8 will be 0. 5 minus 9. Now, is 5 minus 9 possible? Not a chance. So, I will borrow 1 from here. This will become 0. 5 will become 15. I hope you have understood. I will borrow 1 from here. This will become 0. And 5 will become 15. 15 minus 9. Just calculate on the hand. 15 minus 9 will be 6. Is 0 minus 4 possible, students? 0 minus 4 is not possible. So what we will do, we will again borrow from the next number. 9 will become 8. 0 will become 10. 10 minus 4 will be 6. 8 minus 8 will be 0. 8 minus 7 will be 1. 6 minus 1 will be 5. Let us revise this sum once more. 8 minus 8 is 0. 5 minus 9 is not possible. So we borrowed and became 15. 15 minus 9 will be 6. Now 0 minus 4 is not possible. So we borrowed 1, it became 10. 10 minus 4 is again 6. 8 minus 8 is 0. 8 minus 7 is 1. And 6 minus 1 is 5. So this is how we are doing the subtraction of numbers with the borrow technique. Okay. Now finally, before we end this class, you remember in the addition section, we discussed one topic that was called identity element, correct? Now, I will write one or two fill in the blank just to understand. Say, first fill in the blank is 7268 minus dash will be 7268. Second will be, say, 96993. Minus dash equal to 6993. Okay. Now, what is the meaning of identity element? That number in addition that we are adding that will give us the same result, that is called identity element. That number that we are subtracting, which will give us the same result, that is called identity element for subtraction. Now, as you can see, 7268 minus what will be the same number? It is 0. 6993 minus what will be the same number? It is 0. So please remember, students, that 0 is the identity element for subtraction. Okay, fine. So this way we can do the thing even for addition, 0 was the identity element. Even for subtraction, 0 will be the identity element. What is the meaning of identity element? That the final answer is not changing. All things are remaining the same. Fine. So I hope, students, you are all very, very clear with subtraction, with the method of borrower, with the method of normal subtraction. And in the next video, we will meet and see some word problems of subtraction. So that will be all for me. Thank you and have a nice day.